long as they ain't fucked with me or mine, me or none of my people, you know what I'm saying? Me or none of my family or some shit. You know what I'm saying? So I still respect them, but they don't get the full level, the full measure of respect. But me, I'm a real respectful nigga, man. I respect all people. Like, you know, and I don't fear nobody, but I respect everybody pretty much. And I don't go out of my way to disrespect nobody. Even though I don't fear a motherfucker, I don't go out of my way to disrespect nan motherfucker. Unless it's war. And if it's war, then you done already disrespected me as a man. And then I bring it to a nigga. But other than that, like, or a motherfucker had to do some real foul, sour shit to really just make me have no respect for you. Like, you really had to do some foul shit for me to just lose all my respect for you, my nigga. And that's for anybody. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, certain type of niggas, though, like bully type of niggas, you know what I'm saying? Them niggas gotta fear a nigga to respect a nigga. Like, a bully type of nigga, if a nigga's like a bully type of nigga, then they gon', if they don't fear you, they gon' do some disrespectful shit to you. Or they gon' try to pull some kind of bullshit on you if they don't fear you. That's how a bully type of person is. A person who is like a bully, they got that bully mentality, they not gon' respect you unless they fear you. They have to be in fear of you to really respect you. Because if they not in fear of you, they gonna disrespect you, or they gonna try to pull some kind of bullshit on you. They gonna violate you in some kind of way unless they fear you. So I never have a problem when a motherfucker fear me, because I be like, if a motherfucker fear me, it's a reason that they fear me. If a motherfucker, because I don't really do a whole lot of shit for motherfuckers to fear me. But if a motherfucker fear me, I know that that's probably the type of motherfucker that would probably pull some bullshit on me or probably violate me in some kind of way if they didn't fear me. So I don't have a problem with motherfuckers fearing me, because that's probably what's making them act right. That's probably what's keeping them from violating a nigga in some kind of way. So I don't really have a problem with a motherfucker fearing me. But a real nigga ain't gotta fear me, because a real nigga gon' respect me off the top. A real nigga gon' respect a nigga off top until you do something to lose they respect. You know what I'm saying? A real nigga ain't gotta fear me. A real nigga gon' respect me, and I'm gon' respect him off top until one of us do something to lose, you know what I'm saying, the other person respect. You know what I'm saying? That's how it is when you're dealing with real niggas. You know, but some people fear me. But the people that fear me, it's good they fear me, because they probably the type of people that would try to violate me in some kind of way, do some kind of bullshit, do some kind of disrespectful shit to a nigga if they didn't fear me. So I don't mind a motherfucker who fear me. If a motherfucker fear me, they probably need to fear me. And that's probably what keep them from pulling some bullshit or violating a nigga or coming at me in a disrespectful kind of way. So I don't mind when a motherfucker fear me. But a real nigga ain't got to fear me. And you know what I'm saying? And I know I ain't fearing no nigga. You know what I mean? So a real nigga ain't got to fear a nigga, because, you know what I'm saying, respect off top. Unless a nigga violate and do something to lose a nigga respect. You know what I'm saying? So that's how I feel about fear. You know what I'm saying? Because fear will definitely keep a motherfucker in line, though. I know that, nigga. You know, that's really how the mob move, nigga, through fear. Nigga, intimidation and shit. But I really ain't on that shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm just about that respect, nigga. I ain't got a motherfucking, have a motherfucker scared. But like I said, the ones who is scared, it's good they scared. And they probably need to be scared, because they'll probably be on some bullshit, disrespectful shit that turned into all out war. So, you know, the ones who scared, they scared for a reason. You know what I'm saying? But a real nigga ain't gotta be. But that's how I feel about fear. That's how I feel about lying. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole breakdown on this rap battle shit that I got going on right now. And, you know, and that's my history with them niggas. You know what I'm saying? And And that's how them. That's my motherfucking opinion about the whole rap battle. The you know what I'm saying, the other legends in the game that done, you know what I'm saying, did rap battles and shit. That's how I feel about that rap battle shit. And those how I feel about the other niggas who done battled, you know what I'm saying, the greats, Jay-Z, Nas, Pac, Biggie. And Pac always gonna be a legend. I ain't taking nothing from him. But that nigga ain't God, though. That nigga ain't no God, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? We all look up to Pac in certain kind of ways. But I ain't, you know what I'm saying? That nigga wasn't perfect, though, my nigga. You know, he wasn't, you know, he was human, my nigga. He got caught up in his own emotions and in his own jealousy and let another nigga gas him up. Like, Pac was far from perfect, nigga. Pac is not the nigga you should try to be like. And I'm talking to any nigga. Pac, nigga, Pac was Pac, my nigga. You be you, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Pac ain't the nigga you need to try to be because Pac wasn't perfect. Now, don't get me wrong. That nigga had heart. That nigga was wild. He had wild ways. And that nigga had heart. Now, you can look up to that. But, like, that nigga wasn't just... He wasn't just perfect. And everything that nigga did wasn't real nigga shit. Everything he did wasn't real. My nigga, the whole battle with Biggie, that wasn't no real nigga shit. That was some bullshit, really. You know what I'm saying? But that nigga was so powerful when he started going in the wrong direction with all that power, nigga. God had to shut him down, nigga. But he was a prophet, so he knew it was coming. And he didn't know when, but he knew that shit was coming, though. But really, though, that nigga, well, nah, I was gonna say he wasn't really just on that death shit till he got with Death Row. But nah, you gotta listen to Me Against the World. And he was always on that death shit. He was always on that death shit, though. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not like Pac, nigga. I don't feel like I'm gonna die. I know I don't even know if I'm gonna die, my nigga. I might be here when Jesus come back, my nigga. But at the same time, a nigga might die, you know what I'm saying, for this prophet shit. But if I die, nigga, I'm gonna die for Jesus, though. I ain't finna die for no bullshit. I ain't finna die for no motherfucking Suge Knight. I ain't gonna die over no bullshit, cause I done compromise my anointing, nigga, to sell records, nigga. Ain't gonna be no bullshit, nigga. If I die, it's straight for Jesus, nigga. Believe that, nigga. Or I'm sacrificing myself for my motherfucking people, nigga. If I die, it ain't gonna be no bullshit, nigga. It's gonna be some real shit, not no Illuminati sacrifice, nigga. Nigga, if I die, nigga, it's gonna be some real shit. I'm gonna be sacrificing myself for some real significant shit, nigga. If it ain't Jesus, it's gonna be for the benefit of my motherfucking people, nigga. Real nigga shit. Ain't gonna be no bullshit, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? But that's my thoughts on all that, on battle rapping and the battle rap shit that I'm involved in right now. You know what I'm saying? And lying and fear. And that's how I feel about all that. And, you know, and also the prophetic anointing, how powerful that shit is, nigga. If a nigga ain't protected by God, nigga, I could just rap about a certain nigga dying or getting killed and keep rapping about the same shit. I bet you that nigga get killed if that nigga ain't fucking with God and under the blood of Jesus. But I wouldn't do that shit, though. I wouldn't do that shit unless I really wanted to kill a nigga. I wouldn't do that shit unless I really wanted to kill a nigga. And then if I did that shit, God would deal with me. You know what I'm saying? God would deal with me. You know what I'm saying? But I wouldn't do that shit just over no rap battle shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't do that shit. You know what I'm saying? It's certain lines that you don't cross. If certain lines you cross, you're going to get dealt with either by people or you're going to get dealt with by God. It's certain lines that you don't cross, especially if you got a real prophetic anointing and you know the kind of power that God is giving you, then it's certain lines that you don't cross. You know what I'm saying? Or you're going to get dealt with by people or you're going to get dealt with by God. You know what I'm saying? There's certain lines you don't cross, though. You know what I'm saying? But the prophetic anointing ain't no joke. You know what I'm saying? Pac had the strongest prophetic anointing of any other rapper. That's what made Pac who he was. It wasn't because the nigga was so gangster or the nigga was so much of a thug. that nigga had the strongest prophetic anointing out of any other rapper. But if you ask me who's second, I'm going to say Nas, though. Because that nigga Nas be really prophesying shit. You know what I'm saying? But shit, nigga. Okay, I ain't even going to put myself in that. But, hey, fuck with your people, nigga. But, hey, I ain't going to try to compare myself in who number one and number two and all that. But, hey, nigga, I know myself, nigga. I know what God gave me, nigga. I got a strong prophetic anointing. You know what I'm saying? But I know it's certain lines that you don't cross, though. You know what I'm saying? Especially if it ain't real beef. Because if I really had real beef with a nigga, I probably would rap about a nigga getting killed. I rap about niggas getting killed all the time, but it don't be specific niggas, though. It just be in general. You know what I'm saying? But I wouldn't rap about no certain nigga just getting killed over and over like Pac did about Biggie. I wouldn't do that shit unless it was some real beef, like a nigga done really done something to me. But then if I really got real beef with a nigga, I'm going to be trying to see a nigga. I'm going to be trying to run up on a nigga. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to really be trying to rap about it unless I just can't get to the nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I got real beef with a nigga, I'm going to really be trying to physically see a nigga. And the only way I would really rap about the shit is if I just can't get to the nigga, so I can't do nothing else but rap about it. That's the only way I really be really like rapping about a specific nigga just getting killed over and over. But Pac did that shit to Biggie. And the fucked up thing about it was them niggas didn't even have no real beef. Nigga, God would have let Pac slide. God would have let Pac make it if him and Biggie had real beef. But Pac anointing was so powerful, and Pac kept speaking so much death over Biggie, and Biggie was speaking death over himself too. But Pac was speaking so much death over that nigga, and that shit came to pass. Nigga, Pac was speaking so much death over Biggie that God wouldn't let Pac slide with that shit, because that shit wasn't no real beef, my nigga. If Biggie had really done some real shit to Pac, if Biggie would have really had something to do with that nigga Pac getting robbed and getting shot, God would have let Pac slide, speaking all that death over Biggie. God would have let Pac make it, nigga. But Pac and Biggie didn't have no real beef. You don't speak death over somebody over and over like that when you got a powerful prophetic anointing like that, unless it's some real deal beef. And that beef was bullshit. You know? All right, man. I done laced y'all up. I done put y'all on game like I always do. You know what I'm saying? God, I thank you. You know what I'm saying? For giving me revelation, giving me knowledge. And I am that mouthpiece, nigga. And we finna wrap it up. My phone rang. And Jesus up. Holla back. Yep.